Good morning. It's really, really early. And I'm taking the XT to Motorstore Barendrecht. And considering the flat tire, I'm doing that in the most short route possible. In the shortest route possible. So I did a little bit of illegal bicycle lane to cut off some corners and whatnot more. Today will be a very, very busy day. We decided, or I decided, the royal we, that I let Motorstore Barendrecht fix it. Me buying a inner tube at the other garage near my parents. And if I bring the tire there, he will replace it for free. But then we have to do the whole tire removal thingy again ourselves and placing it back ourselves. And the price difference between dropping the bike off at Motorstore Barendrecht and them fixing it in 30 minutes or so, they said, is that small of a difference that time-wise is not worth it. Normally I tend to do stuff myself, for many reasons, financial being one, but in this case I had to cancel other things that were planned and stuff like that. Oh, you can really feel that it is soft here. But yeah, so many other things planned for today and tomorrow that I just didn't saw it happening today, or I had to cancel a lot of things. Then I had to do it Wednesday, which would be interesting. But yeah, not ideal. And another 4 days without a bike. So at which point do you say, okay, now it's smart to, you know, fix it the fastest way possible. If they can fix it in 30 minutes, then I don't have to cancel any plans. I'm taking corners like a pussy, but yeah, I don't know the state of my tire, man. I think it is 1.5 bars now. You can really feel it surging and sliding. But I will take a photo or two for the Instagrams. I am slowly more and more getting used to the Instagrams. It sounds so easy, but when you're looking at it, there's actually quite a lot of stuff behind it. It isn't just post pictures and hope for the best. So yeah. You can follow me there, you can follow me of course on Twitter, you can follow me on the Facebooks. Only advantage of being early, this early, especially on a Saturday, it is quiet as balls on the road, so that's good. And next to that, of course, you can subscribe to the YouTube channel. You can give this video a thumbs up and like and comment. Thumbs up and like, of course, is the same thing. And there's some big channels out there who sometimes, you know, do small little experiments, by a lack of better term. Either don't say, you can like this video at all, or mention, don't forget to like 4 or 5 times. And the more often you mention it, the more likes you get. So, for the YouTube algorithms, there's that bloody term again, it's probably best to spam your video full with don't forget to like constantly, like every minute, every opportunity. Of course that will become annoying in its own, but yeah, if that delivers more likes, then that might be the way to go. I'm not big enough that I should care about the number of likes or not. Then again, if I want to get big enough, I might need to care about the number of likes. If that makes any sense at all. Oh man, I can't wait until I have a new tire and make corners normally. Zo, thank you to the Motorstore Barendrecht. That feels way better. Not quite sure how much bar they put in it. Not really important as I'm not riding that much today. Quick errand or two and that's it. Tomorrow it will rain and then it's a working day again. So most likely Wednesday I will drive towards my dad to pick up the rear protectors, you know, from falling. So the axle sliders for the rear. Because we kept those off, knowing that the tire had to come off again, so. And to pick up the rear passenger stands. That was the problem with the bolt that was missing. They haven't got any new bolts yet. So either I will keep it off for the moment or I'll find some other bolts somewhere in my storage. My dead storage. Until the new ones will arrive. He noticed obviously that my rubbers were gone. The shock absorbing rubbers. I knew that they were in pairs. I think I showed a picture of it on the last video. Woo! Slippily slide. Yeah, I think I showed a picture of that. And he asked, you know what, should we replace those now? Well, we had it. So I kindly asked, what do they cost? He said about 12 euros each. I think I found them a little bit cheaper online, but then you get the shipping costs and maybe not the original brand, so in the end it doesn't really matter price wise. And you know, them being taking maybe 10 minutes extra time is the room I had for myself, so I decided, you know what, fuck it. If it's gonna cost me, let's do everything in one good try so I don't have to take the tire off myself anytime soon. He did check the whole inner wall of the tire itself to see if the thing that punctured the inner tube didn't still live in there somewhere, but we didn't find anything. I could show him the hole, but he checked the whole inner side of the tire. So yeah, I think it was a very interesting morning. I did check out the bikes there a little bit. I didn't have any time to talk because they were busy. But I did give a quick update on my Instagram. Because that is why Instagram is for. So yeah, the bike is in tip-top condition for the new season. Other than a good clean and at some point probably a sprocket and a chain, but he didn't complain about the sprocket, so still fine. I think, if I remember correctly, this is the hospital that had the first corona death in the Netherlands. So let's continue our journey. So yeah. Also, the Netherlands has the first corona death. It was, and I'm again from memory, a older guy, 86, 87. He is of age, who was already intensive care, who had some problem with intestinal disease. Yeah, he wasn't healthy. They're only not quite sure how he got it. So it's slowly developing here as well. And with that very pleasant note, I'm gonna end this one because I don't want to make it too long. I want to say thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, the whole bish bash. And I'll see you in the next one.